As thousands flocked churches and different places for the New Year celebrations, the Prime Minister of Uganda, Robin Anabanja, urged Ugandans to plan for socio-economic transformation in the new year. In Kakumiro, the fireworks that lasted for over 5 minutes excited residents as they chanted slogans to support the NRM. The revelers were entertained by several artists, including Nins Henry. In Kagadi, the Episcopal Vicar Kagadi Vicariate Hoima Diocese Peter Kaberenge urged Christians to denounce selfishness but to work for the glory of God in the new year 2024.
Don't keep regretting. Don't keep. God is not going to keep regretting on you. So don't keep regretting. Look forward and be grateful and thankful. And when you do that, God opens your way.
Christians who attended service called for peace, harmony, and sparing money for education of their children ahead of the new year.
As the year starts, save some money so that you take back kids to school. Because, you know, as a parent, the best investment you can make for your child is education.
It is important to share with other people. Don't be selfish. Because whatever you give away, all you give away, God will always multiply and return it to you in millions.
The Bishop of Ankole Diocese, Right Reverend Fred Sheldon Mwesigwa, noted that God has better plans for Uganda in the new year 2024. The Bishop urged Ugandans to fight corruption and selfishness, which he attributed to some of the problems faced in Uganda.
Corruption is a big problem, even the President was mentioning it, because you take the worst of the worst so that you produce the best of the best? Impossible. But I have confidence that God being our guide, we shall get there.
Bishop Mwesigwa made the comments while addressing a fully packed congregation who turned up for the New Year prayers at St. James Cathedral, Ruharo, the headquarters of Ankole Diocese. Reverend Canon Bobs Nathan Mwesije, the Dean of St. James Cathedral, held Christians for supporting diocesan development projects.
We want to appreciate the mayor who was able to fulfill his pledge of 1 million Uganda shillings towards Mother's Union Complex. It is very unfortunate many politicians have not fulfilled their pledges.
This is your cathedral. Now we want to appreciate you, and we want to appreciate your great and wonderful efforts that you put in to love us.
In Mitiana, residents gathered for a free medical camp to enable them enter the new year in better health. Residents were warned to avoid self-medication and always follow the directives by the health officers so that they can avoid contracting some diseases.
You take the medicine without testing. It is not only malaria that causes rise in temperature. There are other cases. But if you get the rise in temperature and you take coatem, that means you are creating resistance. If you take the underdog, you are creating resistance. Your body will not really. The parasites that you are just suppressing but not eradicating in your blood will eventually become resistant to the blood.
If you always go for testing, give in your blood, get the results. If you're positive, then you get the treatment. If you're not, then you know why you are negative. And the reason might be that you sleep in the mosquito net, then keep doing that.
The beneficiaries commended the organizers of the medical camp and promised to engage in activities that will enable them to remain healthy. In Chiware, the Minister of Finance, Planning and Economic Development, also Wiyanja County Member of Parliament, Matia Kasaija, ushered in Chiware residents to the new year in a style amid celebrations. Residents were united in an event staged at Chiwedi Playground, Nyamarunda Town Council in Chiwale District. The event was characterized by local artists, comedians, and all the entertainment was at no cost. Mm-hmm. Minister Kasaija, who began with a holy mass at St. Theresa Chiwedi Catholic Parish and later went for the New Year festivities at Chiwedi Playground, called upon residents to embrace work so as to meet their New Year resolutions. Minister Kasaija was accompanied by his wife Maria Kasaija, who asked parents to take care of the girl child. She also condemned increasing early marriages and teenage pregnancies. Residents applauded the minister for ushering them into the new year. Meanwhile, Hoima City dwellers thronged churches, hotels, bars, and other happening places to usher in the new year 2024.
We are grateful to the Almighty that we are still among the living. Yeah. You see, whenever you're still alive, you hope for the better.
Some of the people that we have talked to say that they expect to get jobs in 2024, good health. Others have prayed for peace and security. At exactly 12 midnight, the whole of Hoima City was lit with fireworks blasts that took place in various places like at Boma Grounds, Mika Eco Resort, Glory Summit Hotel, HB Hotel and Contic Hotel. In Iganga, residents joined other people in different parts of the country in engaging in prayers as they ushered in the new year 2024. Most of the people gathered at Chigulu Hill Primary School for the Passover prayers organized by Pastor Patrick Chaligonza of True Gospel Miracle Church. Some of the believers who attended the prayers share their experiences for last year and their expectations in the new year.
Achievement that I'm hoping, like getting new jobs, driving, building, stock constructing, and so many other things.
My children are going to school, and my parents, they all arrive.
Story compiled by Ismail Kasoha, Abdukarim Sengendo, Luke Kajiri, Thomas Tumwebaze, Ambrose Niwagabakatoto, and Ivan Wachibi for the news.